Hello friends, Real Chair Gang, Therese here, and welcome to my initial reaction review for Doctor Who Flux Chapter 3. I don't really know what to call this, because I can't really do a full-on in-depth review of that episode, because it felt just like pure questions, really. I can't lie, that episode, the cracks started to show a little bit for me, because up until this point, I've been quite enjoying Doctor Who Flux. I don't want to be misconstrued as just, you know, hating it for the sake of hating it. If I think something's good, I'll say. But this, to me, felt like a Chibnall episode in the worst way possible. It was essentially just another hour of setup and teasing and questions for the rest of the series. And it's gotten to a point now with me, with Chris Chibnall episodes, that trick can only be effective so many times, I feel like, and just, I feel like I'm at a point now where I want to be getting answers for some of the questions that these stories present. Like, there's all these hints, and to be fair, we do get a couple of things. They do tell us, you know, what Vinda's life was like before, and we get a Ruth Doctor reveal, which was really nice, and we get that whole past segment, which I really appreciated being there. But I feel like it raised more questions than it did anything else. And when they tried to be all emotional with the whole, you've got a kid and a girlfriend slash wife who's on the run in the Flux, it's like, I don't care because I don't know this character. I don't connect with Vinda. I know they tried in this episode with the whole flashbacks to things he didn't want to be in, but for me it just sort of rang a bit hollow. And also, there's just some bits of this that just felt really slapdash. Like, obviously, I don't want to be mean. I know that this was an episode filmed within COVID precautions, but frankly, some of the CGI in this looked terrible. Like, the opening shot with the Daleks looked absolutely horrendous. I think I've genuinely seen fan films with CGI that looked better than that. That just took me right out of the story. It also really took me out of the story that, like, one girl was able to take out, like, 20 Cybermen with the equivalent of a space pistol. Like, what? And then there's just, it just felt like a bunch of setup and random scenes that weren't connected. I kind of feel like what the critics felt like of episode one. And I liked episode one, but I acknowledged it was a bit of a mess. But episode three had none of the charm that I felt episode one had. And I'm just not really impressed anymore by constant questions and ball tickling at this point. It's kind of gotten old for me. Maybe I'm the only one who feels like this. Maybe everyone else loved this. But for me, I'm just a bit sick of, like, these constant, ooh, what's this, what's that mystery box type thing. You know, I felt that with the Chibnall era, like, that's what everyone wanted to get away from, was that sort of Moffat-y story box storytelling where it's just these constant weird arcs that don't make sense, like, right till the very end. And I feel like that's what we've gone directly back to. And this, to me, was the biggest indicator of, yeah, this is still Chris Chibnall writing it. And it's a shame, because obviously I'm not saying that, you know, Chris Chibnall, because he is writing it, you know, I'm not saying he can't have his own unique flavor, but what I am saying is it reminded me of the weaker aspects of him as a writer and as a showrunner. It essentially was kind of what Fugitive of the Doom was, a bunch of setup, no real consequence to much of anything. It was just scenes of characters doing things. And I know what people are going to say. People are going to say, okay, it's, you know, episode three in a series, a lot of it could be answered. And that very well could be the case, and you probably are right. But for me, it just kind of felt like just randomness, and it wasn't a good way of establishing a mystery. It's just stuff that, like, it's not going to have any rewatch value in the future, is I guess what I'm saying. It's going to have a similar effect to Fugitive of the Dune, where it's chucked out, everyone goes crazy over it, and then it just quietly sort of gets abandoned once we actually know what it's going for. And I'm just not on board with that form of storytelling anymore. It's just gotten really old to me. I hope I'm not the only one who feels like this, and I don't want to be a party pooper, I don't. But I'm just at a point now where constant questions and, ooh, look, it's a Cyberman. Ooh, look, it's a Weeping Angel. Ooh, look, it's a Dalek. it's not really having the effect on me that it is other people. If you enjoyed this episode, fantastic. I'm happy for you. But I just... no, this wasn't for me. But let me know what you guys thought in the comments below. I apologize for the lack of editing in this video. I have to get it out as quickly as possible to beat the rush, as it were. But thank you all for watching this very disorganized video, and I will see you later.